بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أيها الأحبة في الله، توبة repentance to Allah Azza wa Jal is something that Islam sees as a very important religious duty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with the tawabin wa mutatahirin, those people who purify themselves, and those people who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And making tawbah is a type of spiritual repentance. It's spiritually removing yourself and distancing oneself, seeking expiation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the sins that we constantly commit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabihi al-kareem, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and all of you beg Allah to forgive you, O believers, that you may be successful. So if you want success in this life as well as the hereafter, it's through tawbah. It's through repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is advice first and foremost to myself and then to my brothers and sisters in Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabi al-kareem, استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, seek the forgiveness of your Lord and turn to Him in repentance. And Allah Azza wa Jal also says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, turn to Allah with sincere repentance. So be sincere in your tawbah. And that's one of the conditions for making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, the scholars have outlined some very important conditions for making tawbah. And Imam Nawawi wrote about this in his book Riyadh al-Salihin. He said that the conditions for having one's repentance accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is first to desist from committing it, meaning to stop doing those sins. Secondly, to feel sorrow for committing those sins. And third, to decide not to recommit those sins. So being stopping the sins, feeling sorrow for the sins that you've committed, and being determined not to revisit those sins. So by removing oneself from the environment of sin with a determination to be away from that sin and ceasing to do that sin, then these are the preconditions for tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول والله إني لأستغفر الله وأتوب إليه في يوم أكثر من 70 مرة. رواه بخاري. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, by Allah, I seek Allah's forgiveness and repent to Him more than 70 times a day. This is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What about us with all the sins that we commit? So seek pardon and seek forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal. These are the sifat of a mu'min. This is the characteristics of the believer. This is what distinguishes the believer from those people who are weak and persistent in sin, is that Ahli Iman, they come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They seek refuge in Allah. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Ta'zeem Allah wa ta'zeem tawheedihi wa deenihi. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exalting Him, and holding his religion to be the greatest and most valuable thing. It's the most precious thing that a believer can have. So repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says, وَتُوبُوا لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّوَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And all of you, beg for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, O you who believers, that you may be successful. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil, and bless us to be of those who come to Him and repent often and turn to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah forgive us of our many sins and bless us all with ikhlas, with thabat. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless the Muslims everywhere and guide and give relief to our brothers and sisters in Syria, in Iraq, and Philistine, and Yemen, and Somalia, and Ethiopia, and wherever the Muslims are being oppressed, and our brothers and sisters all over the continent of Africa, and wherever they're suffering, wherever they find difficulty in oppression. And may Allah protect us from the evil of the wicked sinners, those people like ISIS and Boko Haram and Al-Shabaab, those people who distort the image of Allah's religion, and those people who discourage people to make tawbah but encourage people to kill and destroy. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.